total of measuring the micro units, that is mainly plant powder drugs that in pharmacology we need to cover these field micrometer as well as optical micrometer. That is the calibration process, and we measure the fiber, pathway diameter, lipophilicity, and calcium of these crystals using the ocular micrometer itself. So, while the calibration is required, that is, the stage micrometer is graduated or edged with a 0 to 100 units, and this will be measuring about 1 millimeter. And each unit will be having a 101 millimeter, and it will be around 10 microns. Okay. So here the ocular micrometer which we are using for the measurement of these fiber length or the starch veins. This ocular micrometer is not having any units. So it is divided into 100 divisions but doesn't have any units. So for that purpose we have to standardize or calibrate this ocular micrometer. And this method, in this method, we are using the stage micrometer for the calibration of our ocular micrometer itself. There is the stage micrometer which is divided into 100 units or 100 divisions, and here 1 millimeter of a stage micrometer is divided into 100 divisions, and each division is 0.01 millimeters, and 1 millimeter is equal to, that's 1000 microns. And 100 divisions of a stage micrometer is equal to 1000 microns. So one division is 10 microns. So this is the calculation what we are using. That is for the standardization itself. And let's come to the what is stage micrometer and what is ocular micrometer. So this is the stage micrometer, and this stage micrometer is a the slide which is edged with the 0 to 100 divisions, and it is measuring about, is measuring 1 millimeter itself. And this is the ocular micrometer which is spherical in shape, and here it is also edged with the 0 to 100 units, but it doesn't have any units itself. So only the divisions can be seen here, and mainly this stage micrometer is to be kept on the stage of the microscope, and this ocular micrometer is to be inserted into the eyepiece of the microscope itself. Okay. So let us come to the procedure, that is how we calibrate the this ocular micrometer itself. So we have to adjust the stage micrometer as well as ocular micrometer, that is in the superimposition position itself. And the first edge, that is either 0 of the stage micrometer or any of the divisions, which will be made easier to measure the units itself. Okay, so you can go for a 0 or 10 or 20 like that. Then you have to adjust the ocular micrometer itself to the one of the units and make it as a first unit itself. Then you have to superimpose and take it nearer to the this stage ocular micrometer. They have to be taken closer to superimpose, and here the coinciding division, that's the nearest coinciding division, is to be identified. So in this case we have identified the stage 10th division of the stage micrometer. Okay, 10th division of a stage micrometer is measuring around that's a 14th division of a ocular micrometers. Okay, so here for the calibration purpose, 14 divisions of ocular micrometer is equal to 10 divisions of a stage micrometer, and 1 division of a ocular micrometer is equal to 10 divided by 14, that equals to 0.7. So this doesn't have any units, but when you multiply the calibrating factor, so this we consider it as a calibrating factor, and this is multiplied with the 10, and that will be the total value of this calibrating factor will be 7 microns itself. And so these units we are using for the measuring of the fiber length, starch length, nylon length, as well as the calcium of crystals, or any other units which are the these cellular contents which are there. So those things can be measured using this stage, this ocular micrometer itself. So let's come to the procedure, that is the 3 micrometer which is edged on 0 to 100 and it is measuring 1 millimeter cell, that we are keeping it in a state micrometer cell, that is on the microscope. And this ocular micrometer is to be kept in the eyepiece. You have to open the eyepiece and then you have to keep the ocular micrometer in the eyepiece itself, and it is to be confirmed that the numbers are properly placed. That is, it should not be, that's the reverse number should not be there. So that is to be confirmed. So then we have to observe the lines of the stage micrometer. You adjust the stage as well as the ocular micrometer, and you can find the superimposition of a, that's coinciding, nearest coinciding region you have to identify. Can be made with the high power as well as low powers. That's once the calibration is completed with the high power as well as low power, then you can go for an experimentation. That is, here the units, the ocular micrometer you are using for a different microscope itself, so what it is to be calibrated, that thing one should remember. That is, the ocular micrometer, if it is calibrated, then you can make use of those values for the calculation purpose itself. So let us come to the experimental part. That is, so already we have established the superimposing property of a superimposing of this stage as well as the ocular micrometer. Then that is the 10th division of a stage micrometer is coinciding with the 7th division of a ocular micrometer, and that is what it is focused here. Synchrona powder for the determination of a fiber length. So this synchrona fibers, the fly fibers of synchrona, they will be measuring around 500 microns to 850 microns to 1350 microns. So that is the range, and the highest one will be around 1350 microns itself, and the lowest one will be around 500 microns. And similarly, in case of the cinnamon bark, it will be varied. So let us take the synchrona powder and clear it with a chloral hydrate. That is, the powder is to be taken in a test tube, and then it is to be treated with a chloral hydrate and boiled for some time. And then you have to take out this clear powder onto the watch glass, which contains the equal quantities of fluoroproconazole concentrated acid, and then you have to take this material, that is a stained material, onto the slide, and put the cover slip. So remove the excess of glycerin. Remove the excess of glycerin with the help of a filter paper, and you should not find the fibers of this filter paper on the slide itself. So after the calibration of this ocular micrometer, we have to remove the stage micrometer and place the slide which contains the powder of this synchrona, which is stained with the fluoroproconazole concentrated acid itself. So here you have to concentrate on the fibers which are stained, and those fibers are to be measured.
it has been focused that the fiber length determination, we have focused the synchrona bar powder, which is where the effluent fibers are stained. So here the fiber will be measuring around 44 divisions. Okay, 44 divisions of this ocula. So here, if you put the 44 divisions, and then calibrate the value with the 7, so that will be giving you the length of the fibers. And similarly, we have to rotate the ocular micrometer, and then we have to measure the thickness of the width of the micrometer, this width of the effluent fiber itself, and that will be that is around 5 divisions, and here 5 divisions of the multiply with the calibrating factor, so that will be giving you the 35 microns. Okay. So these values will be recorded for a 25 fibers itself. Okay. So then the highest length, this fiber length, that is to be noted, and the average, and also the lowest value. So these three values are to be given. So that is about the fiber length determination.